Okay, here's why the office mobile game is bad, and why mobile gaming is done. Mobile gaming is over. We're done. Place your phone directly into the sea. No more phone games. I can't do this anymore. I can't take it. We are not doing them anymore. I've decided it. And Google Play and the Apple Store have agreed we are not doing any more mobile games. I saw an ad for this game and I was like, okay, let's go. Let's see about this office game. So I invited the Pestilence directly onto my phone. I thought, I watched The Office. I love Jim and his GF. I could play the office game. I thought it might be one of those episode-style story games from the look of it, but nope, it's a clicker game. Kind of. You meet Cartoon Network Bitmoji Michael Scott, and he tells you about the game's currency. Scott coins. I'm not sure if this is an allusion to weird custom Bitcoin currency, but it really feels like it, and it makes me think about Dogecoin, so that's already strike one in this game. The structure of the game is that you click on each character's desk to get them leads, and the more leads they have, the more cash they make, with which you can buy more leads. Standard clicker game fare, except that a good clicker game will emphasize the weird little thrill of the clicking action, at least in the beginning, and this game just doesn't have this. The clicking part feels oddly de-emphasized, and it doesn't help that you're constantly being interrupted by Michael's end-of-the-day tapping race, where you have to slam all your fingers onto your phone as fast as possible to get some sweet Scott coins before the office is reset to a new day and a new episode, and you have to start getting those leads all over again. Most clicker games rely on an ascension or reset mechanic through which you get to reset all your little clickable assets to zero in order to add on permanent underlying boosts that make those assets ultimately more powerful. That's the click cycle. It's part of what makes clicker games addictive, and it's how you become the Joker in his most manic state and end up getting to those huge scaled up numbers. But the office game doesn't have that. It doesn't. Michael simply has you reset once you have reached enough milestones. These are listed at the top of your screen with a progress bar, letting you know how close you are to the boss challenge at all times. Once you reach these goals, you get to do the boss challenge, for which you need a boss power, and then you're thrown into the next episode where you're punished with the reenactment of some dialogue from an episode of The Office, and you must start from scratch. This might not be so bad if you are able to gain decent permanent upgrades during an episode, but the upgrades you get feel more or less completely inconsequential. So functionally, it's as if your clicker game just booted you fully back to the start every so often. The fundamental fun of a clicker game is not here. It's gone. So immediately the game feels like a chore. And what does it offer to combat this? Well, in typical mobile game fashion, it lets you watch some ads to gain extra cash or coffee. You can pretty much do this endlessly. Doing it for cash will add a multiplier to your earnings for a few hours, but doing it for coffee will just give you a really small amount of coffee that does almost nothing to put a dent in the gargantuan amount of coffee the game needs for various upgrades. So this one feels like the biggest waste of time possible, but I will do it. I will watch the video of the stern lady judging my pitiful brain age. She doesn't even know me, but okay. I will suffer her judgment. I will enjoy anything for Michael Scott and his 500 different game currencies. I am a soldier. I am a warrior. Despite the game's weird structure and excessive use of currencies and new events every other day, it's not complicated whatsoever. You gain leads, you upgrade desks, characters, and sometimes little items on the characters' desks. Woo! And then you lie in bed and conjure up depressing scenarios for a bit too long before you can fall asleep. But this game thinks you are a stupid idiot baby, so it gives you an endless barrage of tutorials. Like, I'm not kidding, the first 40 to 50 minutes of this game are almost wall-to-wall tutorial. As if I haven't played Cookie Clicker before. As if I haven't pledged my life to those grannies. As if I wouldn't see a cookie on the street right now and start pummeling it like a fully activated female Gollum. The game also prompts me to download more bytes every time I open it, and while I'm used to that from a game like Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links or Final Fantasy VII The First Soldier, the Final Fantasy Fortnite game, this is like being asked to download more data in like Barbie's horse racing or something. Like, what? What are you talking about? The funniest thing about this game is that when it's doing its fun dialogue from the TV show The Office, it edits the dialogue so everyone's talking about Scott coins. Wow, that's the currency from the game. Remember that show you love? Yeah, you can relive it. Except now, every episode, Michael is really into Pokeballs. I'm just amazed that this was a licensed IP, because besides my hatred for it generally, the game feels unfinished. There's a weird lack of sound at some points. The Scott Coins dialogue stuff has the most powerful bootleg energy imaginable, and the fact that every time you start an event you have to do the same tutorial feels like a mistake. That's not intended, right? Tell me you didn't mean to do that. There's also a glitch that can happen when you view ads, where instead of seeing an ad, you'll just see a black screen and have to restart the app. A huge shame, because of course I love to see ads. And there's a bug which deletes all of your cards if you close an event, making the game even more punishing than it wanted to be. Universal Studios may as well license this IP to a fart from my ass for all the respect this paper-thin app has for its source material. Come on, just stop it.